Hi, boys and girls. Wait, where are you? Are you? What? Wait a second. There you are. What are you guys doing over there? Okay, wait, let me fix this. Let me sit here. Ha ha. Hi. It's me, Mr. Sunito, and I got another book for you for today. Bam! This book is called Mrs. Chicken and the Hungry Crocodile. Are you ready? Let's get right to it. The title of this book, as I told you, is right here, Mrs. Chicken and the Hungry Crocodile. Now, I'm going to try and hold this so you can see the front and the back cover. Who do you think the characters in the story are? Mrs. Chicken. And what's that? A very hungry crocodile. Now, this story was first told in a country in Africa called Liberia. So I'm going to show you where Liberia is on my map. Let me see if I can bring this over. I think I'm just going to do it like this. And we'll go boop, boop, boop. See that? Okay. Now this is the world. We've seen this map before. And we've got the continents. Continents. Do you know your continents? North, south, east, west, all around the world. There's Australia, Asia, Africa, and Europe, North and South America, Antarctica, too. Now, we're in which continent? North America. What country? United States. We are in the city of Chicago, and we're close to that spot. But Liberia is not in North America. It's on the continent of Africa. So we're going to travel down here. Here's Africa. And Liberia, it's on the western side. Let's see if I can, it's probably about as large as I can make it. But Liberia is right there. So this is the country of Liberia. And that is where this story comes from. So back to the book, Mrs. Chicken and the Hungry Crocodile. And I want to show you, oh, look at that. And we've got the authors, Win Liddy Pei and Margaret H. Lipper. And this was illustrated by Julie Pashkis. But we've got a note about the story that I want to read to you. And it's right here. And it says about the story, Mrs. Chicken and the Hungry Crocodile is a traditional story from the Dan people of northeastern Liberia in Africa. The Dan people are rice farmers who are known for their storytelling, wood carving, masked dancing, and music. One Liddy first heard this story from his grandmother, Gowo, when he was very young. Now, this story is a folk tale. A folk tale is a story that is retold or told over and over many years. They tell it again and again. Folk tales often have animal characters that solve a problem using clever tricks. Let's see how Mrs. Chicken solves her problem with the hungry crocodile. One morning, Mrs. Chicken took her bath in a puddle. Cluck, cluck, she said proudly. What a pretty chicken I am. Big, bright eyes, short, smooth beak. But I can't see my wings. This puddle is too small. Now, boys and girls, What are you looking at when you see yourself in a puddle or in a mirror? Do you know what we call that? Well, that's called a reflection, and Mrs. Chicken is looking at her reflection in the puddle. She walked down to the river to get a better look. She didn't know the crocodile lay in the river all day long, waiting for her dinner. What do you think is going to happen next? Uh-oh. Mrs. Chicken leaned over the water. She said, I still can't see my wings. I see scaly green legs and a long mouth with sharp teeth. But where is my beak? Crocodile lay very still and waited. Yum, yum, she thought. That's my dinner. I look different in the river, said Mrs. Chicken. She turned to one side. Crocodile did too. Mrs. Chicken turned to the other side. So did Crocodile. I'd like a closer look, said Mrs. Chicken. She stepped into the river. Uh-oh. Snap! Crocodile grabbed Mrs. Chicken's foot in her mouth. Bawk! Said Mrs. Chicken. Let go! Yikes. Crocodile shook her head. She dragged Mrs. Chicken to her house in the middle of the river. Then she slammed the door shut with her tail and opened her mouth. Mrs. Chicken flew up to the rafters. That's the top of a barn, the rafters. Come down, Crocodile said. I'm going to eat you up. Me, Mrs. Chicken squawked. You can't eat me. Oh, yes, I can, said Crocodile. But, said Mrs. Chicken, you shouldn't eat me. Why not? Asked Crocodile. Boys and girls, Mrs. Chicken is going to try to convince Crocodile not to eat her. I wonder how she can do that. Because, said Mrs. Chicken, I'm your sister. Ha, 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 Crocodile laughed. You're not my sister. You have speckled feathers. I have green skin. You have a beak. I have a mouth with sharp teeth. And these teeth are going to eat you up. No, said Mrs. Chicken. We look different, but we're sisters. I'll prove it. Just give me time. Boys and girls, is Mrs. Chicken really Crocodile's sister? I don't think so. How do you think she will try to prove that they are sisters? This is tough. All right, chuckled Crocodile. I'll fatten you up. The longer I wait, the plumper you'll get. Crocodile yawned and curled around her eggs. Soon she was snoring. Mrs. Chicken made a nest in the corner opposite Crocodile and settled down to lay her own eggs. Every day, Crocodile gave Mrs. Chicken grain to eat. Every night, they fell asleep over their eggs. Mrs. Chicken got fatter and fatter. Crocodile got thinner and hungrier. One evening, Crocodile said, "This is your last meal. Tomorrow will be my big dinner." "We'll see," said Mrs. Chicken. She waited until Crocodile was sleeping. Then she carefully put her eggs next to Crocodile. She took Crocodile's eggs to her own nest. Boys and girls, why do you think Mrs. Chicken is switching the eggs? Just before dawn, before the sun rose, Crocodile felt something move beside her. Mrs. Chicken, she called, wake up! My babies are hatching! But why do they have those silly little beaks and scrawny little wings? They look like you! Look at the crocodile's eggs. My eggs are hatching too, said Mrs. Chicken. Look! She stepped off her nest. Oh, said Crocodile, what beautiful babies you have. What gorgeous green skin. What lovely long mouths. What darlings. They look like me. And your babies look like me, said Mrs. Chicken. I told you we're sisters. You almost ate me. Your own sister. I'm really sorry, Sister Chicken, said Crocodile. Look at the crocodile hugging the chicken. Aww. I have an idea, said Mrs. Chicken. Since you like my babies so much, you can have them. I'll take your funny-looking babies instead. Oh, thank you, Sister Chicken, said Crocodile. Don't mention it, said Mrs. Chicken. Sisters help one another. So they switched babies. Time for us to go home now, Mrs. Chicken said. She and her babies climbed onto Crocodile's back, and Crocodile carried them across the river. Bye-bye, sister, Crocodile said. Mrs. Chicken waved her wing and hurried her chicks up the riverbank. See you soon, said Crocodile. No, you won't, called Mrs. Chicken as she disappeared through the trees. Come along, children. Cluck, cluck. No, you won't. Since that day, Mrs. Chicken and her children have never gone near the river, and they always take their baths in puddles. Big enough for us, Mrs. Chicken tells her children, and much too small for crocodiles. Boys and girls, what has Mrs. Chicken learned from her experience with Crocodile? Now, one more thing. This story is a folktale. That's a story that's been told over and over again over time. Many folktales have talking animals, and they teach a lesson. What do you think the lesson is in this story? Think about that while I get set up for our writing activity. All right, boys and girls, as I'm getting set up to do my writing, why don't you go get set up to do your writing too? You can grab your writer's notebook and a pencil and some crayons and come back to the video when you're ready to write. Now, at the top of your page, you can write the title of the book, Mrs. Chicken and the Hungry Crocodile. And of course, you can put your name right there. What we're going to do is something a little bit different. We're going to think back to the story about all the things that happened. And the things that happen in a story are sometimes called events. And we're going to write about what happened in the story. But we're going to make sure that we put all the events in order. So I'm going to start you off. Now watch me do this. Let me get a nice pen here. Let's see. I'm going to start by writing the number one. The numbers will help us keep the events in order. And I'm going to think back to the beginning of the story. What was the first thing that happened in the story? What was the first thing? Well, you can go back and watch the video, but if you think hard, you might remember that Mrs. Chicken did something. Do you remember that Mrs. Chicken was taking a bath in a puddle? Yeah, so I'm going to write down the first thing that happened. And you can put this down in your notebook too. You can write with me. Stop the video if you need to. But I'm going to write Mrs. Chicken, and I've already got the spelling at the top of the page. Remember to use that capital M and put a period after the S. That's the short way of writing Mrs. Mrs. Chicken, and we want a capital C with chicken because that's her name. So Mrs. Chicken, what did she do? She took a bath. Okay, took, T-O-O-K, she took a bath, th. What two letters make the th sound? T-H, took a bath, and she took the bath in a puddle. Okay, so I'm gonna write in. I'm going to go to the next line, a puddle, p, sound it out, p, p, d, d, and there's two D's, puddle. Now, to go with that sentence, I'm going to do just a quick little picture. So Mrs. Chicken is taking a bath in the puddle. So I'm gonna use, you can use your crayons and put your picture underneath. And let me see, I'm going to draw her maybe like this. And of course your drawing does not have to be perfect. This is for fun. We just wanna have a little drawing to go with it, like that. And I can put her beak right there and give her eyes, like that, and maybe a wing. Something like that. And then I have to put her in the puddle and draw the puddle. And if you want, you could color that in later. Now, let's think what happened after she took a bath. Okay, so she took the bath, and I remember that she couldn't see all of herself in the puddle. Oh, yeah. So then she went down. Do you remember where she went? She went to the river. Okay, so I'm going to write another sentence. I'm going to use more paper. So the second thing was she tried to see herself in the river. So let's write that sentence. She tries, tries. It's a tricky word, try. T-R, she tries to see herself. So there's two parts, her self in the river. And we'll put a period at the end. Now, I'm not going to put a drawing for everything. You don't have to do that. One drawing is fine. What else do you remember happening in the story after she got to the river? After she got to the river? Oh, yeah. Who did she find there? What did she do after she found that animal? How did the story end? Well, what I'd like you to do is see if you can remember three more things, three more events that you could write about. Now, you've already got lots and lots of words that you can use, like Mrs. Chicken, hungry, crocodile. We've also got puddle, river. See if you can get all the way to number five. That would be terrific. Be sure and take a picture and show me your writing in ClassDojo. I hope you have a great day, and thanks for watching. Bye, boys and girls.